has everything.
Big Boy's Neighborhood. All righty. 50 Cent is in the neighborhood.
Okay.
Early in the morning.
Yes, hey. My brother. Welcome back to the neighborhood, man.
I'm happy to be here, man.
Go ahead. Now, make sure that mic is right in front of you, Phil, because I got a lot of questions for you.
I'm ready.
First off, man, why did you show your dick?
You know what?
Please, tell
Let's
us.
Get right to it, man. I can't. You know, let me get this out the way. You know what I'm saying? Now, for one, you got the hottest show with the TV show Power. The hottest show. And I mean, like, Everyone's watching it, and we all got to kind of be on schedule. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because
that's why I moved it from Saturdays to Sundays.
Yeah, okay, that was another
Saturday
question.
Saturday is the party night.
Yeah.
Right.
Sunday, you wind down, get ready, go back to work.
And then we come in, and it's bad because we have to do that. Did you see it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Did you see it?
Like,
and then if
me.
Somebody didn't see it by a certain date, we like, okay, well, you know what?
You had that
much
time.
Now we got to spoil it for you.
Yeah, and you know what's crazy is the project, because for me, in the very beginning, I was working with Courtney Kemp, right? And we was compiling information to create the characters. Mm. So it was like I was taking people that I knew, their behaviors and different things, and kind of putting it into like multiple people into one character.
Right.
So and then we created it. And then when Courtney like brought it to life, I mean, like she's really responsible for the show being the hit.
Don't tell her that.
Yeah.
You don't want to say that too. Is Courtney a guy or girl?
This is a girl.
Girl. Yeah. Don't tell her that because it's a powerful show.
Yeah.
She did that.
It was all you, man. It was all you. It was all you, baby boy.
She's just like her structure, like, and the pacing of it is what makes it special because it allows you to feel invested in the characters because we see imperfections in them that we can identify with.
Right.
It's not ours, it's someone else we know.
And you know what, man? It's a show, Power to Show, man. It's like, it's not cheesy. You know how some shows, it'll start off and it'll be like, oh, man, this is me. Then it turn out, you're like,
what?
Big, I can see it early. I was going, yo, This is going to be the best show. I told, like, I had started the comparisons between Empire and Power.
Yeah.
And it was like.
And I remember that because you did a campaign, Jack. I was like,
remember that?
I was like, Lord have mercy, campaign. Man.
Because they came behind us and they, like, borrowed it. Because they hit the bullseye on the targeted demo that we was trying to hit with the show. And then they had, their plot having the Lucius character be connected to the music business versus, you know, ghosts being connected to nightlife.
Right.
And music always right. being in the club. So it's like, there was points that there was things.
You felt a certain way about that, though.
Yeah, I was like, it was pretty similar. But not the characters.
Right.
Yeah.
Like, I love Taraji. I love Terrence Howard is in my first film.
Yeah.
You know, like my co-star for Get Rich or Die Trying. Like, he's like, the original title.
So
for
it's not them.
Nah.
Right.
Now I see them. I'm like, hey, come here.
Right, you know?
Taraji, I'm like, yo, shut up.
Do we ever want to say, like, man, I wish I was on Power? Have they had that conversation with you
yet? Nah, they haven't said. You know what you do? Taraji will go, 50 with his bullshit. Like, you know what I'm saying?
There you go. Man, don't get away from the fact of why, Fifth, are we watching this show? Now, for one, there's a few questions.
Yeah, right.
We didn't know that the penis shot was coming.
Yeah,
that
was, man. Well, came out of nowhere.
You know, it was interesting because it was a harder scene. Like for a
no
sexy,
pun intended.
No, right. big. What happens when you do the scene? If there's a like in a sex scene, you can go into the regimen of things that you would do.
Mm-hmm.
I saw something had come up with Halle Berry when she did the monster
ball. Yeah. Yeah.
That they kind of felt like she was doing a little bit of her, like her relationship, kind of sort things
like that, certain things like blend into the.
To the real.
Right. Bring some of that realness in.
A lot of the sex scenes, though, on Power, like, sometimes like, I wonder, I sit here and I'm like, do Angela and Omari really have sex in real life?
Nah.
Because,
you know,
it's like,
crazy.
It's.
They got like this
I'm thing. Telling you, homie, if parts. I was like 13, this would be something to jack to.
Yeah, you definitely
think
like
about
a soft
when you didn't
porn.
Have all this.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
So
I would have been
porn.
Like, man, Sunday porn, nights, I'm going to sleep well after this show is over. Now, Fifth, I don't want to talk about anything else. I want to get past this
right.
penis shot.
Look.
All righty, so we're watching it. There is no, you the king of social media. You didn't say, hey, my penis is going to be shown tonight. So fellas, you know, make sure you don't
back.
Watch this. Yeah.
Warning.
For one, did you know?
I did. I know. And when I did, Big, was I was like, I can't believe Courtney did this.
Right.
Like, I got upset with it in front because I didn't know how the guys was going to respond to it.
Oh, so you did know.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I had to do that. That was my disclaimer for you.
Go ahead now.
Like, I was doing that.
I knew.
And then, you know, the ladies will look, and then If they don't respond positively about it, then it was a total mistake.
Now, let me ask you this, man. And Fiv, I wish I would have threw this to one of the girls to ask this. But is that, like, we were talking off air, is that really Fiv? Or did y'all have something? Because I think it was you that brought it up.
I kept on saying that I didn't think it was your actual part. I was like, man, they planned this. It's a prosthetic because it was just the tip that showed. Like, maybe it was all planned. I don't know.
No, big, it was the, you know.
That's you.
Yeah.
It was yours.
So somewhere there's some girls out of your whole career that's like, hey, I recognize that.
I see that.
Yeah. Like, girl, no, that
he
is him.
It. I know it personally.
Yeah, like, that is him. With the show power, man, did you know going in and creating and putting the characters together, Fiv, did you know that this was going to be as successful as it is? And there's no expiration date to it.
Well, if I don't feel like the project's going to be successful, but I can't work on it. Because I try to find a way to pass the responsibility to someone else because I'm like, this is not going on.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like,
you do it.
I got to feel that, like, to continuously stay on the project. And then there was a point that the Courtney was like, look, I gotta go back to work.
Oh.
Because like, we worked on the project and we pitched it. We went and they kept going, so who's going to play Ghost? You're going to play Ghost? And it would mean that I would, 9 months out of the year, I would have to be on the show. Mm-hmm. So I was like, no, I got a good idea of who would play Ghost, you know, like, and then we had Amari in mind at that point, but we hadn't had anybody really, like, get on the actual.
Let me ask you this, Fiv. Now, with Starz, you know what I'm saying? Starz, the channel's been around for years.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But we didn't go to Starz and say, oh, I'm watching Starz tonight. Or you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, you have really created an entire fan base for people that didn't know that there was a network that's been there for years.
And now the beauty of it is they are reciprocating that energy.
Yeah, I see that.
So Starz is responding to me in a way, like, they're like, so, okay, what's next?
Yeah, hell yeah. Awesome. I would, too.
He said, "Cause
that's dope.
It's doing really well." So now they
but what about when you talk to people early on and there's a vision there and you say, "Oh man, we're gonna do it on Starz." Even with the cast, I would be like, "Starz,
Starz, yeah." But you know,
man, what Starz?
Just the premium cable space is not gonna be, look, it's not gonna pay out as much as it would pay to be on network television,
right?
Mm-hmm. Like the Empire budgeting is bigger. This is why I made those comparisons, so I'd be connected to their marketing. So people would think every time you saw that, that's the show 50 don't like.
Right. Yeah. I remember you cleverly, it was something that you had got in on.
He put a commercial in between the finale, bro, of Empire, remember?
Oh, man.
For Power, the show.
Bully. All right. Yeah.
Savage.
So now, when we're talking about the actual, just people believing in the network. Now the network believe in you. But did you have any resistance? Even when you told business associates, man, we're going to take it to Starz, that was like, oh.
No, they were fine with the idea of putting it on the network. It didn't have a stigma around it. It was more like at any moment it could break. And now you got Chris Albert. Like, he's responsible for HBO Sunday.
Mm-hmm. You're right.
Way it is. You know what I mean? So now with him there and he's saying, okay, he bet on me and then the power just goes.
Because I would go after you. Because at one point, you know, it was like, oh, Netflix. Oh, you can get a movie. They can send it out. It could be in queue. And then they give you, like, Orange is the New Black. And now everybody's like, man, I got to get to Netflix.
Yes.
Now everybody, if Starz pop up now, I'm like, hell yeah, I'll go to Starz.
It's a different thing. And then they got the app, so it allows people who don't have, like, cable television to just put it on their phone.
Yeah.
And instead of streaming it, it allows you to download the episodes as they come. So you can watch it on a plane, baby.
Yeah,
it's like
man.
A different, like, and they're just conscious of things that the other companies aren't conscious of. Like when you're traveling, you can't stream. Like if you watched it on your telephone through an app, you stream it, now you can't. You're dead, baby. You ain't got no action.
Man, now do you still watch or are you? What's ahead? God, I don't want to do this, but what's ahead? You know what I'm saying? Like because if we're sitting here tripping now. Is there something else where you like, oh, man, no. Y'all ain't seen
it? It's way more. Like, the plot, the twists and turns in the plot it's so intense that it'll sustain the interest all the way through the season. Like, this is what I was saying, because when I watch, like, I see everything big. I see dailies, like the shot where you didn't say the line right.
Right.
I see that.
So
see
you hands-on.
Like, I'm watching it because I'm going, when you watch the Dax Cloud, this is the only way we can keep the quality control. Where I make, like, a lot of people make the editor's film.
Right.
Meaning they just shoot coverage. As much cool
and then get in the booth and it'll come together.
And then put it in there with the editor and, mm-hmm. and see what he chooses, what he did creatively, and try to make the best possible project like that. And then sometimes you got directors that make the director's film. So they'll mm-hmm. look and they'll go, that's it. You did it. Let's move to the next scene. We don't have to stay on this. We got that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then it's creatively, it's a special project. That's why I try to bring the most exciting directors. Like, we use a lot of film directors on the actual television show.
Are you able to watch the show, though, once it does air as a fan?
Yeah, I watch it again with everybody. Yeah.
I heard that.
You know what I'm saying? So I can, you know, feel that excitement, that energy connected to it. Like, even Doc. Doc is...
Let me tell you, homie, as an artist, you would never have another record played on iHeart.
Listen.
Sorry, Doc, I had to tell him. We're talking about him not sending out, he has social media king. He didn't even send out anything on social media like, hey, fellas, fall back, my penis is going to be like. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's just like, whoa!
What you doing?
Like, man.
What you just, yeah. My aunt go big, she was like, I'm traumatized.
Yeah.
I didn't even know what the And so, I was like, no.
I'm traumatized.
Yeah.
I told her a different story, babe. I said, I didn't know that was going to be there.
Yeah.
I told her I had to do something. She said, I'm traumatized. What is the matter with you? I'm like, you didn't have to do that.
Right. You
didn't have to do. She said, everybody else is doing the sex scene. You didn't do that.
This dude. But the one scene we continue to talk about is yours, though.
Yeah. Team Ghost or Team Tommy?
Ooh.
Team Tommy.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, Tommy.
How come?
He's straight laced. He's not like, look, he might not the sharpest, the smartest character mm-hmm. in the show, but he lives by the rules.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
The lifestyle. Like, Ghost mm-hmm. is, he calling the police at the same time while he
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, those kind of guys, and they out there, killer rats. Yeah. They out there.
Right. Killer rats.
They'll kill you if you're in the wrong place and then call the cops if you show up when they're not ready. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
hey, man, what about Tommy's character saying the N-word on there?
Listen, look, he came with me to my neighborhood,
mm-hmm.
and they didn't refrain.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
They went to going, oh, Tommy, that's my nigga. Yo, look. Boy, when you did that, that's just not like, and they said it's the most he's been called in his life.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
So he goes, afterwards, I said, you know what, to being authentic to the actual character.
Mm-hmm. Right.
If you grew up in the environment,
mm-hmm.
they don't see you as anything different from them once you're not police. Like, they're just working through that barrier of he's not police
mm-hmm.
when he's different. If he's white, if he's Indian, whatever he is, you're under the same circumstances when they're saying it. They're not using it as a racial
right.
slur. They're just saying, like, yo, it's like Fat Joe would use the word in so many different things. Like, and it doesn't ring off. He's been representation of the Latino community in hip hop culture for Lord knows how long. But the environment, we're mixed in, like, we're in a melting pot. Like, in New York, there's so many ethnicities up under each other that it doesn't stand out. Like, when people say it, they just go,
right.
You know, conscious of it are people who could potentially be racist or extremists, people who are so, people that are so conscious of it because they are in that, it's not this time period, but that time period, they're so conscious of it. Like, my grandfather and them would have a different, they would say racial things without me knowing it. This redneck, look at this.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Like, at the TV. When they're talking at the TV, they're from Aiken, South Carolina, and what they've been through in their life, their time frame growing up, it would be things said there that would be considered a racial. It's racial. Mm-hmm. But we know where the motivation is coming from.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's what your fear factor would be, or what you would be. Look, even a...
Was Tommy Joseph, was he uncomfortable when they saw it in the script?
No.
Wow.
No, because he's really in, he get in the mix now to become a character. Like, I brought them to my neighborhood before we started. Mm-hmm. I think they're going to be there for a few weeks before the season starts again. Like, they'll go into an apartment and stay in the neighborhood. Because it gives them, look, big, there was a kid there, was like 13 years old. And he's walking, and I go, yo, I call him, he looked. You would have swore to God he had a pistol on him. The way he turned around, like, he looked like, what? Yeah. And Joe was like, oh, shit, hold up. Right. Yeah. Because it's just the way Shorty responded. And I was like, yo, come here. And he said, what? You called him. And then when he identified it, that it's me, he go, oh, what's up, 50?
Right.
He said, yo, what you doing here? You want me to go get Junior? Because he right there, Junior's like down the block from there. So you want me to go get him? I'll go get him for you. Like, he going, like, but that's a defense mechanism, that tough energy.
Right.
It's like, if you're trying to play me, like, he's giving you the don't play with me energy. And if you would, anyone else would have saw it, like, he could have had a pistol.
Right.
The way he responded, Joe was like, yo, what?
Yeah.
What happened? Like, Joe Shorty looked like he got.
That time he went away, like, he was like, oh,
wait a minute.
Let's get out of here.
My name is Joseph.
We can't build a set that looks like this. Can we get like a set or a warehouse or something that looks like this? So you get them out there early so they can get that texture and that feel as well.
Of how people respond and stuff at the same time. Because that energy is not going to, it's not going to shift. We're not going to go nowhere. When he turned around, he was like, what's up? Like, what you want? He really was saying, don't come over here bothering me.
Right.
Like, what? Like, because you could potentially be calling me to bother me. The only thing that you don't want to become is a victim, because it becomes consistent in the environment. So they want to keep people from playing with them. And let me just do what I got to do. Mind my business, you mind your
business.
You're
not shooting anything like in Bel Air or the Hamptons or anything I could be involved in? You know what I'm saying? You don't have no thing called 50s Mansions or anything like that?
Nah, I got one of those.
Okay, well, when you put it together, let me know. I know you got a lot more work that you're doing.
Yeah, I got a project in development now, the BMF
store. I'll take it. Y'all stick around your radio, man. We got a project coming together. BMF, yeah, the story,
oh my gosh,
brother. Big Meech.
Yep, Big Meech. I got a chance to talk to Meech. I got a chance to get on with T. I actually had dinner last night with Tony. And that's
T's lady. Now, a lot of people, there's reference. You know what I'm saying? Like to a lot of cats, that's like, man, that's a Scarface. You know what I'm saying?
It's a big film. Like,
and a lot of people attach themselves to BMF. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And they don't just hand that to anybody.
Yeah, you know, look, a lot of the attachment is they may have been involved in some portions of the BMF, that lifestyle, and involved in some of the actions, and made some money around the actual scenario. But the story is definitely Meech and Tone and Tori and T's story.
So what are you going to do with this particular project? What's your plan?
This one is, I mean, I had to meet with Starz because I want bigger writers. I want bigger, you know.
Is this a series also, or is this?
There is a series, and then because it's so much, it gives me. Look, I always look at my series like it's going 7 seasons.
Good.
You know, so looking at like 70 hours of material versus 2 hours.
Right. Trying to get it all in, and you miss everything and texture and culture.
And now the series will give you the information that. Over the time periods, that a book can give it to you. Like, just buying the book rights would mean you just bought the court documents and speaking to, you know, the arresting officers and stuff like that. But when you talk to Terry and Meech, you get the actual things that they got away with.
And you had these conversations with them.
Yeah.
That's
crazy. Wow, that's crazy.
So is there a green light already? You like, this is happening?
It's happening. It's
you posted that letter from Big Meech on your Instagram.
Yeah, it's emotion. Because, no, I look and I say, how do I make something that's more, even more intriguing, more interesting than power? Now, we did like a great fictional story that we used real people to reference.
Right.
To create the realness that you feel in the story. And then we made New York City a character in the show that allowed us to put all ethnicities into the show.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, there's areas in New York, you go to Brooklyn, it's just Jewish.
Mm-hmm.
Even the cops are Jewish.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they police themselves. And then you got Chinatown, and then you got uptown in the Bronx, you got Puerto Ricans and Dominicans all over the place. And then it's so diverse that it allows you to have someone see someone as representation of themselves in the show. And that was the idea.
Hey, so now, how far away are we from? Because I know you got to be in pre production right now.
Right.
Is this 2017 or 18?
No, not that far. Well, like 17, I think.
That's gonna be dope as hell, bro.
I pull it together, man. See, and it's like, well, everybody is motivated.
What happens with 50 the artist? Because it seemed like everything take a lot of time to do right.
Right, but this part. But I could read on the plane.
Yeah, I hear you. Hello.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I do.
Do you fly private?
Sometimes.
Go ahead now.
I try not to all the time. Like, if it's a hop and a skip, I'll get on the plane. I don't care. If it's like a longer.
When's the last time you sat in coach?
I have never
sat in coach. Are you serious?
I haven't been in coach since. I think, you know what? Yes, I did fly in coach, man.
Yeah, thank you.
Damn it, that one time.
But when Eminem flew you from. Dre was like.
I had to get on the plane. It didn't matter. I just had to get.
To a show or something?
Yeah, back to New York from Miami.
So other than that, you've never really flown? Because before the 50 that we knew,
right.
You weren't traveling a lot, right?
I didn't get a that's what I'm saying. I didn't get out of the city. When I got on.
You got on.
I got on. I was on, so I was in the seat.
That's a crazy thought to have.
We got
to
do it together.
Hey, dude, yeah. Can we fly coach together?
We could go in the back. We could all be back there.
Yeah.
But don't buy you no safety seat in the front.
Yeah, no, you can't do that.
I'll break out in hives back here.
They gave me when I did sit there, they gave me the what's name seat. By the exit.
The emergency exit. I love that seat.
You don't even know what it's called.
That has room. That's my favorite seat. That has more room.
Yeah, there's a little more room there.
Yeah, yeah. No leg room. Sometimes nobody next to you. Uh-huh. I heard that.
You're in charge of everyone's life.
Yeah. Now you're responsible. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, we jumped out the plane. It was 50. And 50, I recently saw that you and Game were in the same place, so on and so forth. Did you guys have dialogue? Because I didn't see any dialogue. Yeah.
It came and kicked it. It was more like, because I always said I didn't understand.
Right. With like, the so-called
where
beef
it came
or whatever.
From.
You're right.
You know what I'm saying? And I looked, like, why he explained it to me, and I was like I really didn't get it, though. Like, because I think it was really Jimmy.
Jimmy?
Jimmy Henchman.
I hear you.
Like, his issues with the way the younger crew out in New York in different areas perceive me. See, because that, like, the Preem, like, when I had issues with John, the guys that were supporting him, that was the real issue.
Right.
They had an aura around them that was so strong that when you don't, they didn't teach me how to back down, babe.
Right.
They told me a lot of stuff, you know what I'm saying? And they would just didn't teach you how to accept that you just took that L and you just need to just take that. You know, then you're just a sucker at that point. So I'm looking at it like, nah, you got an idea. I got a different idea. You know what I'm saying? And like, I just would go head first into it. So we had the things that I was saying it before, you know Preem got life in jail. Like, before that happens, like, everything that I said, they were still on the street. It wasn't like I was saying it and there was no repercussions to what you were saying. Like, you don't tell somebody who got you shot 9 times that you're going to blow their head off when you see them and don't mean it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And then from that was confirmation that to a lot of the younger crew that, nah, he about that. He ain't going to say that and not mean that. You know what I'm saying? Like, and you just got up from getting hit 9 times. So he's going, I like 50.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, because that confirmation is in it. And what happened is with Game, from my perception of it, is Jimmy's issues was with Chris originally. Because Caesar Entertainment was like a management company, while Violator Management
right.
was what that was. So he felt like he should have a lot of the stuff that Chris was having, the action. And Chris having me as an artist made him not want Game to be under that umbrella. You see what I'm saying? So it was like, move him away from, you don't need that. You got a whole coast. You see what I'm saying? Right. Like, you over here, the West Coast, instead of you being here on the East Coast. And this is a guy from the East Coast telling you don't need that. You need to be over here. You got a whole coast. Like, it's this idea to have it, like, I have something separate. It's not connected to 50 Cent. Even though it required my assistance to get it to that point. You know, and then it kind of moved things away. Like, I really didn't, it's not something that I was pursuing. Like, if beef is over with me, squash beef, if you see me somewhere and nothing happens, means I'm not pursuing it.
Right.
Because I will stop doing what I'm doing to have the altercation. Like we'll do it right there. Like, every time. If there's a problem, if I'm passionate about it, then we're going to deal with it right there. Every time. It's not, I'm not going to see you in passing and not Exactly. Address it, unless it's just not right because it's police or
right,
just,
right.
We on an airplane.
The kids' softball game.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? The right place.
Oh man, if I take one of these bats right now, but yeah, like, little kids' game. But so when you see when you in game, y'all at the was it Ace of Diamonds or something something like that?
Yeah,
some
yeah.
spot. Which yeah, well, always I, call them the water anyway.
We seen him before that because one of his homies got relationships with some of the guys I deal with in New York, and he's a real like he's. A good guy out there. So he came and he told me that they was coming in, like they wanted to come into the club. First they asked, the nightclub owner would come ask, is it okay?
Right.
And I go, yeah. Like, let him in. You know, so you could be in L.A. and you're going, is it okay? Gaming them outside, they want to come in. Like, it was a couple times before that they turned them away, places that they came that where I was at. And I was like, let them in. Like, you know, like.
It wasn't you turning them away. It was club, just somebody else with the bigger.
Immediately
with
they, is with going, no.
Right.
This.
And I'm pretty sure it's probably happened to you as well.
Look, I haven't been. I just started moving around with effing. Oh, like okay. Being out like that all the time. So now it's. For them, they'll go to these nightclubs. Just like. I wouldn't go if I wasn't being promoted to be there. Mm-hmm. The night that I'm being promoted to be there, they're coming. To party. Mm-hmm.
Like, right. I hear you.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't just go like for no reason like that. And then there was like. When we have, like they'll know that we had some sort of friction at some point, and go, I don't want that in the building.
Right, I hear you.
You know, because even if it's not 50 in game, if it's his homeboy and somebody else that is not kind of cool with each other, mm-hmm. and they get into an altercation, mm-hmm. then it creates liability for the club. Mm-hmm. So they just can't handle that kind of action anyway.
So he's in. Everybody's in and everything is...
It's cool. He's just on that side of the room and we're chilling.
Did y'all dialogue?
Not the first time. That was Playhouse.
Okay. What about the one that we saw?
Did y'all... Yeah, Ace. Yeah, he came over and we talked that time.
I heard
he said, well, he got a chance to tell me how he really felt about it. And I was like, you know, I mean, it's cool. Like, he really felt like he had to get that off his chest because I never did nothing to him, babe. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, he just wanted to say, you know, they he didn't have to go that route.
Right. Mm-hmm. So where do y'all leave at now? Do I need to write something for y'all? Or?
Nah, we're in the same place.
Oh, here I am. Did anybody know like, who ghost write right. for him? My
bad. He cool. Like, I haven't wished bad on him the entire time. Mm. You know what I'm saying? It's been more like, if I spend my time and my energy on wanting someone else or trying to see someone else down, how can I pull myself up?
Right. Well, you usually do it you so know? Well. I was just wondering.
Yeah, mm-hmm. just focusing on that. Like,
nah, it is
as you pull yourself up, yeah. people who make themselves direct competitors go down anyway.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Like, this is interesting. Like, you don't have to focus on bringing, you know, like pulling someone down. Like, if people in perception become more respectful to the things that you accomplish in your career, they'll look at other people that are just saying things about it. It's like the guy at radio that decides to attack you to get his notoriety.
Right. I hear you.
You know what I'm saying? And they go, who's that again? Like, I mean, that's big. Like, we know how long we know you to be a successful, you know, personality on radio.
Mm.
I seen buildings change, babe.
Well, yeah, quite a while.
I seen buildings change. Like,
I mean, it has.
I kind of wanted some money when you got the new
gig. Wow, look at him.
What do you mean?
I felt entitled.
You did.
I said, how many good moments did we make?
We created a lot of great moments.
I washed cars in front of the joint.
No.
Yes.
I washed cars.
Yeah, you did.
Remember, I lost that bet. Don't try to rewrite history. I lost the bet to him and had to wash his cars and all that.
He's crazy. Lambos.
Bring up the past. That's why I left. Every time I looked out that building, I would see where I washed that car at. I'm like, man, this is bad memories. Boom, I'm out of here. Yeah.
50, I've seen pictures with you and Donald Trump. And
yeah,
I just want to know. How
I don't even want that picture in existence.
Yes. Okay, good. Because I was just wondering if you really see him running our country.
Nah. I've seen some interesting things from people. And what is really odd about it is like when they make a mistake, I don't see any mistake. In him, like I could see him not see
mm-hmm.
his mistakes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man.
Accountability.
Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, no accountability. So it's like, even when this old lady is saying like, "Word is bond."
Right.
Yeah.
She's Russian. When do you get "word is bond" as a slang?
Or even taking Michelle Obama's speech.
That's man. The took the whole speech.
Yeah,
man.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
I understand where "word is bond" came from, Michelle.
Right.
I get it. When you said it from Russia and they really She could have been a lot better if they would have let her just be who she is. The woman speaks like six languages.
Right.
She could have did something that was so diverse that made you feel like, wow, this is going to be different.
So why are you voting for him?
I'm just making sure.
I just wanted to start something.
That picture made me nervous.
Big, look, don't try to put that kind of pressure on me.
Yeah.
Because some people are going to say, Big said he's voting for.
Right. Or that'd be the clip.
Yeah. The Big said.
We can sit here for an hour and it's like 50 votes for
Donald Trump.
Man, do you read your comments on your Instagram or any
sometimes.
Social media?
Like when what's name comes on? When the power show comes on, I respond to my fans following
that. Hey, man, now there's been so many deaths when it comes to the TV show Power.
Yeah.
How does someone look at you, and how do you look at them, knowing like, man, this person is gonna die?
You know,
like do they like, come on, Fifth?
You know, look at this. Look, they get like, if you ask who's a good guy, and who's a bad guy on Power, they would say Kanan was the bad guy.
Killed Sean.
But he called the police on me, sent me to jail for 10 years.
Right. Okay. I got you.
He raised Sean was technically biologically my son, but his son because he spent. That 10 years trying to be like Ghost. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And in a suit and hanging out and liking Tasha because of his fascination with Ghost. Everything is connected to him over that time period. It's like not only did he take 10 years from me, but he took my son from me in the period because he influenced him in that way. And Sean was sheltered and around his mother prior to that. Now you go, what did I do to him? I just tried to take it back.
Right.
What was mine before he came around. You know what I'm saying? And he's just using, he was able to utilize by any means necessary, like any means at all. But there's no moral compass. It's the guy that says, you know what? I'm going to get that corner, even if I got to call the cops on him to get him out of here to get the corner. Not I'm going to do something to him.
The moral compass. Yeah, because let me tell you, like I said, we all got to make sure that we watch it or else it's going to be a spoiler alert.
Yeah. Yeah. Man.
I was off of when... You know what I'm saying? When you had to do it was like conversation, and it was like, yeah. And I'm like, he killed his son.
I had to.
He said,
the
I had
memes
to.
That were built around that.
But I was off. Yeah. I was like, okay, cool. And then it just like, man,
it was a Marvin Gaye moment.
Okay, right. Oh my lord, yes.
Marvin Gaye moment. And daddy's saying, look, I brought you in here. I take you out of here.
Damn.
He put himself so far into his actual life, and the kid is, you know this person. You know the person that is. More comfortable fighting someone they love than someone that's an enemy.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So they can run into an enemy and be so defeated because they didn't do something that they come home and are angry with someone they love. Because that person is not going to pose a real threat to them because they actually have passion for them. So he's going to say, you're going to leave Ghost, not do what you're supposed to do there. You could have went out of town. You could have got Tasha and went right out of town. And I didn't see you or hear from you, so I had to address the situation. Anyway, right? Instead, you want to come back to me and tell me, I ain't nothing. I'm a thug. I should be in jail for 10 years, and all of this. And then when you get so angry, it builds up. He does it, and then what the significance in the scene is the real significant part is he comes in and he says, "You see what you did? You effed up. You done made me eff up."
Damn.
And then he's looking at him and said, "What you doing? You try to call 911? You a rat?" The fear factor of the kid telling on him now that he's a square. Like, he's not, you're trying to call your mommy. Because your mother's definitely going to tell on me.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? Like, you're trying to call your mother? And then he said, oh, no, your Uncle G. You want to call you love your Uncle G.
Right.
That's how it is, right? Nigga never there when you need him. You see what I'm saying? Like, it's just one of those things, baby.
Hey, man, why did this man just justify killing his
right.
son?
What the hell just happened?
Like, he literally shot him in the leg or something. Like,
wait, no, he just justified it, I guess.
Like, all right, Sean, you deserved it.
Yeah, like, all right.
That's what you get for trying to be like
that. We're over here shaking our heads like, yeah.
That does make sense.
You should have shot him.
Yeah, like, man. Very like, clever writing here.
No, it has to have, for me to perform it, I have to kind of develop a logic that makes it,
you have to.
Acceptable to me, like for the character to be a real person, for the performance to feel authentic, you gotta say, look what you just did to me. You made me do that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
look what you made me do.
It's all your fault.
Yeah.
And it's one of those things because it's crazy. Like,
do y'all have rap parties for people that get killed off? Or it'd be too many rap parties.
This is when we do the table reads.
Oh man. Oh.
And they see it for the first time that the.
It get quiet.
Get emotional.
Oh.
Start crying there because it's like I'm like, this, whoa.
Does your money stop with that episode, or do you get paid out for the season?
Nah, that's it. Right there where you...
He starts pointing at the writer who put it in.
Like, that guy. Man.
Yo, and it's crazy because...
So I would be sitting there like, yeah. Oh, so you going to call your mama? And then I'll turn the page like, well, that...
Look, the actress... Yeah, it really do.
Y'all gonna do me like that?
And you can't say anything about it because it's the bosses in front of you.
Like, right. And it can't like let them know about in advance what the arc is, right, or what's going on, because they need them to be in that portion of the character.
Man, we had the cast here, man. We were trying to crack them open, brother. They, I don't know what kind of non-disclosure or what you had on them, brother. Even off air. Like, come on, man.
Give us something.
What was the story with Amber Rose? Her saying that, like, you offered her a part, but you took it away real quickly.
Amber's show, I think, is interesting.
The one that's on VH1?
Yeah. Her talk show.
I enjoyed that show, man. Like,
she said some wild stuff.
Yeah.
You know, so, and I just... Like, when she talked about the like me communicating with her about the project, I'd never talked to her.
She just putting it in the atmosphere.
She did, and I felt like it was cool though that she mentioned it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, it was one of those things where, like, you know what, Big, I had said some things early on, just rapping, like about when, like, the she went from Runways in Milan to Big Bags Aretha.
Mm.
Like from the Kanye experience to the Wiz Khalifa experience. Mm. And I had ran into Wiz in a gas station. He was by the Lowe's Hotel over there. They got like an alley over there.
Oh, wow.
Like, I had drove past him in the gas station and went through that little alley, came back, and I stopped and said, what's up to him? And she was in the car. And I apologized to him. I apologized to him because I saw that as... With Wiz, with Black and Yellow, I looked at the Amber Rose relationship like it was confirmation of success.
Because
you guys rapping in the basement while you see this woman with Kanye West is at a peak point, and at that point in his career in hip hop. So when you do come, like, and people have things to say about it, like, don't tell me she's not hot now that I got it.
Right.
She was just smoking hot last week. Now you're going to tell me it's not hot because I got it? And then I think that this is what allows that relationship to go to the point of marriage. Because of the perception of the person at that point. Like, I mean, he might have viewed it a little different if he met her like Kanye met her.
Right. Let me ask you this also, Phil. What does all that have to do with you offering her a spot?
I never had a what's that?
Oh, okay. I was just wondering.
I like that he opened up and shared that story.
I didn't know what was going down. I'm telling you that I
personally apologize.
Okay.
Because once it's your wife.
Right, it's a different thing.
Bitch.
Okay. All right, cool. You made me understand you're killing your son. Now I got this. All right. Best believe that. All righty. Well,
just check the ratings. This is good for radio.
Hell yeah. You guys are already talking about season 4 for the TV show.
Yeah, because we got picked up for season 4 and 5. At the same time. So,
oh, man.
Yeah, that they just did right away. Just,
hey, dude, how many people do you see, knowing that show is successful, that has that look in their eyes like, man, can you put me on?
Now I get it.
Do you see it in me right now?
Right. I'm trying to get the same eye this whole time.
Yeah.
Could you put me?
Yeah. Do you see it in me though?
What you want
to
do, man?
Man, I'm ready to. Man, I fly to New York. Man, come on now.
Come on, I could do so much.
Man, it's your show. I mean, if it was really your show, you have
yeah,
me on.
A long time ago.
Not even a long time ago. I'm just talking about season 4.
I'll come be on.
Did y'all, y'all finish? And season 3 is completely done, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, if it was really your show and it wasn't controlled by, you know, and you weren't just a puppet,
ooh,
you know, I'd definitely be on something on season 4. Right. You know what I'm saying? Definitely on season 4,
if you wanted to show, you're really a boss.
Yeah.
Is that what he said?
Yeah.
Put me in, coach.
Right. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? No, I wouldn't even say coach. I would say owner. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, I mean, if you want to sit here and play like it's all your show.
Shots
and
fired.
You know, we know that it's not.
It's not my, look.
Just pretending.
It's Chris Albert's show.
Right. Yeah, you got to hide behind something too, though. Because we out there on you, boy. Now, what about when you just talk about the show Power, and now that it's successful, how many, not I told you so, but how many people coming aboard now like, man, I need to.
No, they hear me clear. They hear my idea.
Yeah.
Now, because people go, so explain
now
to
what
me.
Is this?
So why did, okay, so what do you think is why? You said you knew in advance.
Right, yeah. Like, and then that's your dream.
Yeah, and everybody that's there, like, for the network, they respect that I like I initiated a lot of those things. Like even the running the commercial in their finale, mm-hmm. And then they mentioned the show at the end. So they had written that in to throw their little tap back.
Oh man.
You know, so they ended the show
television
on,
show
on
beef.
The word power.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, television did. Show beef.
This is really good. Yeah. Man. If I could trick them into competing with me in that way, then you know, at the end I win. Like you look now and you see my show is.
You said it. All right. You said it without saying it. All right. 50 Cent is in the neighborhood, man. We're just off air just talking about some of the things that people call beef. Right. Mm-hmm. And at one point, you and Fat Joe, it was a situation that was going down. But now, I remember when All The Way Up came up, you was like, man, I can't front. That's you know.
One of them joints. Like, if you say big, like, a certain music that comes into a culture, like Busta Rhymes had a moment with Put Your Hands Where My Eyes Can See.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That record was like, okay, we make hip-hop music, but that is special. One.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then it just stood out, and it was like, so Bus is always going to be one of those guys to me because he had that moment. Like Black Rob, the Whoa record.
Yeah.
It's like, it was the first time that the whole song was a chorus.
Right.
You know what I mean? And then the only time I've seen that done again was E-40. That, yep.
Yeah. Nope. Yep. Yeah.
Nope. Like yeah. And I was like, oh, man. Like when he caught that, I was like, yo, that was crazy. That record was crazy to me because the entire thing was a hook.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like with Joe, like he had the Lean Back record. I liked that record.
Right.
And it was like, yeah, that's just hot. Like he periodically has a record that you can't really just.
Yeah, you can't deny.
Yeah, you look at it and you go, nah. You're right. Not here by accident.
To say something to be like, now this is really hating if I say this one ain't right.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm not going to say that out loud.
So you hear All The Way Up. Now, are you and Joe, are y'all.
Yeah,
cordial then, before All The Way Up?
Yeah, like we had already, really was Chris Lighty passing.
I got you. Know, like I remember, yeah. Because even then, y'all shared a stage.
Yeah, we did something at that point, and then it was like, you get to a point where it gets old and you go, well, what exactly was we? Because I can't remember exactly what my beef is with you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I know how I feel about this guy.
Mm-hmm.
And then it was like, oh, that's right. You was just standing next to him. So like, and Joe's personality is one of those people that if he's down with you, then he's down with you.
Right,
almost loyal to a default. You know what I'm saying? Like if you looked at it and you say like a person who go, even if a person that you're down with isn't down with you as much as you are.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? And you look and go, you pretty much can't see that they're leaning on you.
Mm-hmm.
Like they're bringing you around for support.
Right.
To have a different energy is because you just when you are who you are, you don't see yourself that way, and you just go, nah, it's just that's my man.
Because I know we did a show recently, and you and Joe were on the bill together.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And I was even thinking like years ago, you know what I'm saying?
Can't
like
do that.
And not that I was gonna funk off, but even as a promoter, you would just say, you know what, man? Either we got to choose one or the other. Right. And we got to, you know what I'm saying?
They would immediately go, no, put one of the two on the show.
Yeah,
because you're gonna make a. You can make a potential mess in place. And it's easy now. Like, we did it again at Dreas, Club Dreas.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That we both came, and the energy is real interesting because you got people that are there, and it's like.
They don't know.
Yeah, they're like, yo, this could pop off any moment.
Like, you know, I think I'm dancing.
Get your camera.
Is that okay?
Yeah. Okay, I didn't know what was going down. All righty, man. Really real. We gonna get through these, Fifth. All right, we're gonna get through these, man. The last time I did something knowing it was wrong was.
Last time I did something knowing it was wrong. Man, I took my little guy, right? I had him with me. We went down.
Your son?
We were supposed to go to Chuck E. Cheese.
Uh-huh.
And then I was just out. But we was riding, and I saw these girls and stuff, and I was like, look, come here. I said, okay, now you go over there, and you be cute. And then I'm going to come over there, all right?
Get you. You know, what are you doing over here? What are
you doing? Come here,
baby.
Yeah, he's cute.
Oh, my God. Look at him.
I'm like, big, he's cute. Look at him. I make these. I have them.
Yeah. And that's better than the puppy. You know what I'm saying?
Baby by me.
What is something 50 can't live without? F and vodka?
No, well, no, I need. I need. What's the name? I need to be around, like, away from people for a little while.
Mm. Where like do you now, go to get away?
Like when I go home, I get away from like everything. I just for a little while.
You still got the house in Connecticut?
Yeah, but I don't go.
You don't go to that one.
Yeah, another place. But when I do go, I just need to just be away from everything for a little while.
How long is a little while?
Like a few hours.
Just damn.
With nobody there, though.
Right.
Like, so I'm just by myself for a little while, and then before everything else starts again.
What is your kryptonite?
Women.
Women, really?
Yeah, I need.
You think, do you ever think 50 will get married? Not wife.
Maybe. Love. Maybe. In the right scenario, maybe.
Gotta get all this power and BMF stuff out the way first. Mm. got work to do.
Yeah.
Craziest thing 50 has done with a stranger that you've never seen again. Aren't you like, that'd be the butt big.
Like, hey, I don't even think that's strange anymore.
Bro. Right, yeah. Tell me about it.
I think, maybe the spending. Like, if you do something that's more, like, I've been places where the place was too nice for who I was with.
Oh, really, though?
Right, like you get off the plane and you look and you go, like, I know this. See, this is supposed to be a part of a highlight reel.
Right.
And the reason why you work your way through things that get rough at points. And you, like... Mm.
Like, she don't understand.
Yeah, she's not going to be here.
I thought you knew.
Again.
I thought you knew, man. All righty now. What were you too young for when you did it the first time?
Sex, first time. I was 12.
Yeah. Oh,
first time. No. It was really. It wasn't bad. It wasn't a bad thing.
The bad thing
is it didn't continuously happen after the first time that it happened. Like.
Right.
So it was like, it just kind of gave you a shot of what it's like in your arm, and then you was like, okay, nah, I had some issues, big. I was rehearsing the power scene.
Yeah, oh, man. What was the last thing you Google searched?
Last thing I Googled was, it was in the car. I just had on my telephone, I was looking at... fighter stuff, like the different new fighters, fight clips.
Oh, man, yeah. You still into your fight game, too?
I'll be watching. Yeah, I like
it. Man, I'm with you, brother. We got to go to a fight. Your treat. All right. if this was, okay, everything was legal for 24 hours.
Right.
All righty. What would you take advantage of doing? Everything is legal.
I don't know. I guess we would purge, babe.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
You would participate in purging.
No, because everything's legal for that many hours. Like, whatever issues you had, you should deal with it so it doesn't come back after the 24 hours.
I heard that. Go deal with every man.
Everybody gonna be gone after he purges.
Hell yeah. Your,
the lawsuit that's pending.
Right. Which what?
It's no longer active.
There
because,
it is. Now, what lawsuit is? Well, we probably get.
Everything that's happening in your life that's creating a conflict.
Mm. Right. Give you 24 hours, you straighten that out, huh?
24 hours, we're flying like, okay, where exactly is the.
Handle that on Thursday, Friday. You wake up like, oh, man.
God is good.
Yeah.
God is good
all the time. 50, man, definitely want to thank you for coming into the neighborhood and hanging out with us, man. Always a pleasure. Next time you come in, man, please answer some of the questions.
Yes. All right, make sure.
All right, good. Lord. I can't answer. I can't. I plead the 50. You know what I'm saying? You need to bring out a book called I Plead the 50.
I Plead the 50.
Yeah, or a song. You know what I'm saying? Where you just say everything. You know what I'm saying?
Great, like, bro.
It's the opposite of I Plead the 50. This dude just talk. Y'all stick around. Y'all Radio 50. Thank you for coming up in here, man. Big Boy's Neighborhood.